Welcome, welcome. We're going to have a short little lesson on template sewing. First off, what is a template? A template is a pattern. It's a piece or shaped wood, plastic, fabric. It's a shaped piece that is used for a pattern to duplicate a pattern repeatedly. So template sewing is what we're going to do, is we're going to understand and know the shapes we use repeatedly, and we're going to put them on our pattern. So let me show you an example. Let's first look at this, the tops. We have the basic bodice, the front and the back. And that bodice, it doesn't matter if it's a jacket, a blouse, a t-shirt, doesn't make any difference. We'll have templates for each of those. So if you notice, center front line is just straight. Center back line is straight. Everybody can draw a straight line. The circumference we know is our size. We get that. But I want to show you, first off, if you look at the red and the green line and the very front, that's a neckline. And what we know about our necklines is generally there's just a few that we really, really like. And so what we want to do is create templates for those necklines. Templates just means a piece of fabric. We have them for sale, but that's not the point of this. The point is, for anyone who doesn't want to buy them, create your own. The only reason we created them is because somebody created them incorrectly, and so I went in to kind of remedy that. But you can create your own neckline templates. Use your French curve. Use your French curve, put it down on your favorite neckline that you have in your closet, and duplicate the numbers, and then write them down and make cardboards, make papers out of them. Our neckline templates have accommodating bands that go with them, so that kind of gives you a little extra edge. But again, it's all just what you want and what you decide. The point being is, if you notice the neckline, what does it connect? It connects center front to the shoulder seam. That's the connection point. So it can go anywhere along the shoulder line to anywhere along center front, and that connection is called a neckline. Then if you notice the shoulder seam, the shoulder angle, it's the same. The only thing it changes is for a shoulder pad. So pretty much everything you sew, you should know your shoulder angle by now. And if you take a line and go to center front, it's a 90 degree angle. That creates the angle of the shoulder. Again, make a template out of that. So we have the neckline, then we have the shoulder, then we have the armhole. We know the armhole is repeatable. We know that we either like a knit, a woven, and how many times do we cut something out and someone says, oh my gosh, my armhole's too low. It's pretty darn hard to raise an armhole up after I've already cut it out. Whereas if I have an armhole template, all I do, that's a template, a pattern that I've cut out that I know I like, I place one point at the shoulder line, one point at the side seam. It doesn't matter where along the shoulder line it goes, and it doesn't matter where along the side seam it goes. All an armhole does is connect the shoulder to the side seam. And the rest of it is really pretty easy. So those three templates put up there at the bodice and the top make a big difference as to how our garments fit. However, they're repeatable. They're patterns that we can understand what we like, we can understand what we are, and we can repeat them in every pattern, in every style that we purchase. These things don't affect the style. Then if we go to our pant, I want to show you in our pant, we have three French curve positions. We have our waist, which follows a French curve. We have our hip, which follows a French curve. What we need is the crotch templates. They follow the French curve, but the French curve pivots, and that's a little bit more complicated to get it right. So if we just trace those templates, once we have put on or we have a pant we like, trace what those crotches are and make a template out of that crotch. A crotch is no different than an armhole. Different place. I'll take that back. It's a different place, but it's the same concept. What it does is it connects the center front to the inseam. That's a connection point. And so it can be higher for knit pants. It can be lower for woven pants. It can be a little narrower for knit pants. So that's why we have all the differences that we have, just like we have differences in armholes for knit, for wovens, depending on what we like and how comfortable we want them to feel. The concept of template sewing is that we learn what we like and then we make it repeatable. We know what we like. I know you ladies. I know you know what you like. There's no question on that. I know you know what you like. What we want to do is measure it, put it down, and then repeat it, or even cut it out of a pattern and then repeat it. The goal is to make your sewing easier and much more fun and much faster to get to that fitted result that we like. Template sewing is what we want to think about. It's not a new coined phrase at all. It's just a reminder to put all those templates together. The goal is, of course, happy sewing from Silhouette Patterns.